Good morning and welcome to worship at Celebration Community Church. And of course, a very happy new year. We're so glad to have you with us this morning. Reverend Swift is away from us this week, but she will be returning next week. But it's our great pleasure to have our very good friend, Pastor Shelby Nolan, in the pulpit this morning. And I know you will enjoy his message. 2020 was, at the very least, a trying year. But the good news is, we are still here. We, the body of Christ, are still here. And we will go forward together as we've done so many times before. To say that I am thankful and grateful that you are here is truly an understatement. But as we head into 2021, I pray that we follow the example of the Magi, that we step forward in faith, surrounded and guided by God's love. The peace of Christ be with all of you.
Our call to worship. Arise, shine, for your light has come. The glory of the Lord has risen upon you. The glory of God shines in the darkness. Lift up your eyes and look around. Follow the star wherever it leads. Take the journey that leads to the child. Let your hearts rejoice. Be overwhelmed with joy. We worship the Christ child, the hope of the world.
Let us pray. Gracious and living God, you call to us across the deep waters in the dark places. Yours is the light which guides us and the voice which we follow. We pray that you will reveal yourself to us as we worship you. May those without hope be encouraged, those who are sad be cheered, those who are seeking find you, and may all things be according to your will. In the name of your beloved Son, we pray. Amen.
Join us in singing We Three Kings.
We three kings of Orient are, bearing gifts we traverse afar. Field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. O star of wonder, star of light, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never over us all to reign. O star of wonder, star of light, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Glorious now, behold him arise, Christ and God and sacrifice. Alleluia, alleluia, sounds through the earth and skies. O star of wonder, star of light, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
An Epiphany Blessing. If you could see the journey whole, you might never undertake it, might never dare the first step that propels you from the place that you have known toward the place you know not. Call it one of the mercies of the road, that we see it only by stages as it opens before us, as it comes into our keeping, step by single step. There is nothing for it but to go. And by our going, take the vows the pilgrim takes, to be faithful to the next step, to rely on more than the map, to heed the signpost of intuition and dream, to follow the star that only you will recognize, to keep an open eye for the wonders that attend the path, to press on beyond distractions, beyond fatigue, beyond what would tempt you from the way. There are vows that only you will know, the secret promises for your particular path, and the new ones you will need to make when the road is revealed by turns you could not have foreseen. Keep them, break them, make them again. Each promise becomes part of the path. Each choice creates the road that will take you to the place where at last you will kneel to offer the gift most needed, the gift that only you can give, before turning to go home by another way.
Will you pray with me? O God of mystery and wonder, God of magi and stars, God of babes in mangers, we come to you in thanksgiving for this life you have laid before us, for the goodness of God, you of all things you have brought forth before us in creation, the goodness of Jesus our Savior. And we come with thankful hearts, also with hearts that carry heavy burdens. We pray for the needs of this world, especially for the sick and the dying, especially those suffering in our pandemic. We pray, O God, also for the first responders, for nurses and doctors and chaplains. And we pray for all those in our congregation, both near and far to our hearts, for whatever needs and concerns they might have. We ask, O God, that you will be with them. You will comfort them. And this time in which we come seeking the Christ child, when we come with wonder and awe, that we will truly be transformed through our worship, through our giving, and through your grace. Amen.
Our prayer is that God would shine on us in this new year, and we will bless his name together.
Lord, let your light, light of your face, shine on us. Lord, let your light, light of your face, shine on us. Your grace.
A reading from the book of Matthew. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. This is the gospel of grace.
Yeah.
Happy Epiphany. And before we begin, I just want to thank you once again for welcoming me into your pulpit. It is always an honor to be in this holy and sacred space, even in these strange and unusual times. Will you pray with me? O God, take our minds and think through them. Take our lips and speak through them. Take our hearts and set them on fire for love of you, for if we are with you, nothing else matters. And if we are not with you, nothing else matters. Amen. We're all looking for some kind of star. As long as humans have existed, we've been fascinated with stars, even to the point that the prominent performers and writers and people of our society become stars. I spent some time in Los Angeles, and you all over Hollywood, you see stargazing tours. You know, it always looks a lot like that portion in I Love Lucy from so many years past when she's living in Hollywood and fascinated by seeing a star. We can all remember her lighting her nose on fire after she had spilled spaghetti on Bill Holden or stealing John Wayne's footprints. I was fascinated when I was there by stars. I remember I nearly had a heart attack when I realized the old man I was sitting next to had been in one small part in an episode of The Golden Girls. Stars are fascinating, whether they be the people that we have given this title to, or they be those celestial beings, those markers, those things that pointed us north, that gave us hope on our families, our ancestral trips across the sea. They're the things that point sailors to where they're going, and they're the thing that in the deepest moment of despair, many people find hope in. We can think back to times when we've been, say, in the West Texas desert, where we've been fascinated and transformed by a star. And we still, many of us, gather around our TVs when a NASA and SpaceX expedition goes out. This human hope of finding out what's up there in the stars. And these magi are no different. They were sacred and holy stargazers who came to proclaim Christ as exactly who we now know him to be. Our ruler of an unusual kingdom, our great high priest, and the one who would sacrifice himself to rise again to new life. But these were people who shouldn't have been the ones to proclaim this message about Jesus. You see, these magi, these astrologers, were of a different religion. They looked to the stars to find answers, and they were not practicing Jews like every other player in the Christmas story. They were unusual and mysterious. They came from parts unknown. In some ways, it would be like one of the fortune teller women outside of the cathedral in New Orleans being the one being invited to bring the gifts to the Christ child. These magi were not what anyone would have expected. They are not who good Jews would have thought would come to bring glory and honor and homage to this baby. But this baby was not what any of us were expecting either. God used unusual, unexpected people, and God is still using unusual and unexpected people. I always stand in awe when I preach for your congregation at the way God has used unusual and unexpected people in this very community to proclaim the good news of Christ Jesus to the world. You gathered here and in homes and in other places for so many years when other churches have said many of us would not be welcome here. Yet that hope went on to proclaim the good news because God had called us, God had called you, and God is still calling the unusual. These magi, these people from the East, these outsiders, they came and they knew exactly who this baby was, even though those around them didn't understand. You see, we think we often miss the point of the three gifts. You see, the first gift of gold was because they understood that this was a king. They come to Herod and ask, who is this new king of the Jews? Which is a radical thing to say to the person who thinks he's the king of the Jews. It scared him to death. And they come bringing frankincense, a sign of a high priest, and give it to a babe in a manger or a small child. They also bear myrrh, something that many traditions say would later anoint Christ's body after his crucifixion. They knew that this new king of the Jews, this Messiah, this Christ, the light under the star, the one who would give life and life abundant, was not a mighty person on a throne. They saw the good news in Christ Jesus in unexpected places, and God used the unexpected people to do the work. And often the church has struggled to accept the unlikely candidates to proclaim God's grace. Those of us who are gay know what it's like to be turned away at the table. Those of us who live in our midst of different ethnicities and races and backgrounds know what it's like to be told they're not fully welcome here. And yet it is those unexpected people that do the work of God. So I want to challenge us to think, who might be these unexpected people in our very midst right now? Who are these unexpected people that are coming to proclaim the good news to us? And who are we not listening to because they come from a faith tradition, a background, a race, and a people, a way of living their life that looks so different and outside of our norms? God is doing a new thing. I also think that we have to look at one other part of these magi. They had to be creative about proclaiming this good news. They go to Herod and they say, where is this king of the Jews that the star has told us about, that the stars are guiding us to? And yet, they knew after meeting him that they had to go home by another way. God has called many of us to be creative about proclaiming the kingdom of God. If in no other time than right now, we have lived out having to go home by another way. As we proclaim the message of goodness, as the sacraments are offered in these ways that are unusual and strange, and for some of us, our voices are getting out to the world for the very first time in spite of the ways we don't fit the picture of the norm. God loves to use the unexpected. God might be speaking to us through that unexpected woman with a word of kindness while she sits there in front as the homeless woman on the street or the odd fortune-telling lady in New Orleans. But the work of God is all around us. We are all magi on this journey. We are all called to come and pay him homage. And we are also called to be Mary, who welcomed these strangers, these unusual people, these ones who, besides her, truly understood who this baby was, to come and kneel and honor him. And so as we go through these next days, as we enter Christmas season, and as we move into a new year, may we come with ears open. Open to new words from unusual and unexpected places. And may we come with hearts open to doing things in creative and new, and albeit crafty and unusual ways. The work of God is not done. it is just beginning. And let us keep seeking our star. Let us keep seeking wisdom that is all around us. And let us come to the one who is Jesus the Christ, the bright morning star of our salvation. Amen.
Follow the star to a place unexpected. Would you believe, after all we've projected, a child in a manger? Lowly and small, the weakest of all, unlikeliest hero, wrapped in his mother's shawl. Just a child, is this who we've waited for? 'Cause how many kings stepped down from their thrones? How many lords have abandoned their homes? How many greats have become the least for me? And how many gods have poured out their hearts to romance a world that is all torn apart? How many fathers gave up their sons for me? Bringing our gifts for the newborn Savior, all that we have, whether costly or meek, because we believe. Gold for his honor, and frankincense for his pleasure, and myrrh for the cross he'll suffer. Do you believe? Is this who we've waited for? How many kings stepped down from their thrones? How many lords have abandoned their homes? How many greats have become the least for me? And how many gods have poured out their hearts to romance a world that is all torn apart? How many fathers gave up their sons for me? Only one did that for me. All for me. All for you. How many kings stepped down from their thrones? How many lords have abandoned their homes? How many greats have become the least? And how many gods have poured out their hearts to romance a world that is all torn apart? How many fathers gave up their sons for me? Only one did that for me.
Now is the time in our service where we will bring forth our offering. Celebration has always been a generous congregation. And throughout this past year, when things were so very hard, you were faithful. We thank you and know that what you have done has helped so many.
With hearts uplifted and filled with thanksgiving, let us come now and give our thanks unto God as we prepare our hearts for the Holy Sacrament. Holy God, we praise you and we bless you for creation, for the gift of your abiding love, which brings us to close to you, the source of all blessing. We thank you for revealing your will for us, for your preaching, for the preaching of the prophets. We especially thank you for the faithfulness of time and the time in which you sent Jesus, born of Mary, to live in our midst, to share in our suffering, and to accept the pain of death at the hands of those who Jesus loved. We rejoice that in perfect victory over your grave, you raised Christ in power to become sovereign in his realm. We celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit to gather your church, to which your work may be done in the world, and through which we share the gift of eternal life. With the faithful in every place and every time, we praise your with joy your holy name, saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. And now, O God, we ask that you consecrate, therefore, by the Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine, and bless that we may receive them at this table, may offer you in faith and praise, and may be united with Christ and with one another, and that we may be continued to be faithful unto you in all things. We remember that it was on the night which Jesus was betrayed. He took bread, broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. This is the body of Christ given for you. We also remember that in a similar manner, he took the cup, blessed it, gave you thanks, and said, This is the new covenant of my blood, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever we drink it, do this in remembrance of me. This is the blood of Christ given for us all. Take now and receive. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that you have knit us together, that you have called us to this place, and in these humble elements of bread and wine, you offer us your very presence, your body and your blood. May we remember that we are what we eat, we are the body of Christ, and may we be ever transformed by these gifts of grace, these gifts of grain and grape. Amen.
Lord, the light of your love is shining in the midst of the darkness, shining. Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us, set us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me, shine on me, shine, Jesus, shine, fill this land with the Father's glory, lay Spirit, blaze, set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow, flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light.
Receive now this benediction. May God give you the grace to never sell yourself short, grace to risk something big for something good, grace to know the world is too dangerous for anything but truth and too small for anything but love, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with us and remain with us always. Amen.